to find all the roots of this polynomial, the first thing we're going to notice is that it can be factored. We can remove a factor of x, leaving 6x cubed plus 5x squared minus 17x minus 6. To find the remainder, well, first of all, this fact tells me that x equals 0 is one of the roots. To find the remaining roots, we can use the rational root theorem to find the possible rational roots. So the possible rational roots are going to be numbers which divide 6 divided by numbers which divide 6. The numbers which divide 6 are plus or minus 1, 2, 3, and 6. If I take each one of these one at a time and divide them by the divisors of 6, if I divide each one of these by 1, we don't change anything. If I divide each one by 2, I get plus or minus 1 half, plus or minus 3 halves. The others don't give me anything new. If I divide by 3, I get plus or minus 1 third, plus or minus 2 thirds. And lastly, if I divide by 6, I get that. So I have a rather long list of numbers to check. I'm going to check these using synthetic division. So if I first of all check 1, I get the coefficients are 6, 5, negative 17, and negative 6. These are just the coefficients from that polynomial. The procedure says I drop the 6 down, multiply, add, multiply, add, multiply, add, and so since this is not a 0, negative 1 is not a root. I'm next going to try another one, and let's try negative 2. Again, I just copy down these coefficients. Negative 2 times 6 is negative 12. If I add, I get negative 7. Multiply, I get 14. Add, I get negative 3. Multiply by, and I get 6. If I add, I get 0. So this tells me that x equal minus 2 is one of the roots. So I have two roots. If we were to now look at this collection of numbers, or this polynomial, 6x squared minus 7x minus 3, we can factor that and get 2x minus 3, 3x plus 1, 3x plus 1. So we get x equals 3 halves and x equal negative 1 third as the remaining zeros. So the four zeros are 0, negative 2, 3 halves, and negative 1 third.